Please note these are a form of social commentary and not in any way meant to put down the ideas and ideals of any political or gender identity. You are all fair game in the eyes of the wicked, and we see you. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Oh shit! I'm Pickle Rick! Motherfucker!
You are now watching Useless Geek episode STS.
How's it going, party people? Today is the 16th of March. Now, just going to go ahead and preface this one by, good morning, Chris, you made it. Just wanted to preface today's episode by just admitting I didn't write a script. So this is really more of a free chat, and I kind of want to just talk about a few things. For one, it's just a really weird world we live in. It's a really small friggin' world, and you don't really notice it until you've been around long enough. So I just got in an Uber today and found out that a guy that I smoked a joint with back in 2007, I want to say it was, is the same exact guy that got my Uber driver into America. So this dude that just shows up and picks me up, we already have a connection. We know the same person. And so I really kind of, it just blows my mind with that, you know, the whole 7 degrees of separation, or six degrees, I think it is, of separation, saying that, you know, every person knows each other through six or less people. Yeah, it's just really weird. All right, let's start our ritual. This week, we got Pop Rocks and soda, the only one that I have not tried yet. So the other one was birthday cake and the same lemon cherry. So let's try this one out. I do not know everyone in the freaking city. I think Chris says that because every time we used to go out just wandering about, I usually run into at least two or three people that I know. That's just, I don't know. I think that's, it's a smaller city than you think, you know? For instance, the big fiasco that happened years ago over at Walgreens with Shia LaBeouf, he ended up getting arrested and kicked out of a Walgreens. I was with him that night. I had met him that night because the Green Day tickets were on sale, and I was at the Vic waiting on Green Day tickets. And Shia LaBeouf, by the time they had given us, you know, because you had to wait till the ticket box opened. So by the time I had gotten my tickets and I could now turn around and leave, I just saw him smoking a cigarette on the corner. So I talked to him and we grab a beer from there's a 1001 Liquors like right across the street. And it's a pretty famous liquor store. So we went there, grabbed a few drinks, and just drank out in public. And it was really cool. I just don't know why he did not want to leave. And I was telling him we should just go, you know, anywhere. But yeah, he wanted to stay there and try to keep people happy. I think he just wanted to be in a big group. Probably didn't want to leave with some stranger he just met, but I was saying, let's just go hit up the bar because no one's going to expect him over at like a place like Berlin. You know, he can pretty much be himself. But, you know, he chose what he chose. And so there's a lot of weird shit like that. If I see Keanu Reeves, hopefully he remembers me. I've met him twice on the damn train and we used to ride together. I don't think it's I don't know. I'm just a social butterfly, I guess. I'm truly my mother's child because my mother was the type of person that knew everybody on the block, knew everybody's name, knew everybody's kid. And that seemed to be every parent on the block. Chris would know because where we come from in Albany Park, the blocks are pretty clicky. I mean, we all know the same people. We all affiliate with the same groups. And whether or not you're, a Chicagoan, if you're in and out of the north side, I'm probably going to run into you. And yeah, I'm always going to talk no matter what. That's what I do. Obviously. Look at me now. I'm literally doing this for free. So yeah, this guy I meet on the bus, he ends up being a cousin of this guy I met that was out of Cambodia. Now, what was really funny, and Chris, you might actually appreciate this, was it turned out the driver that I had was actually from Southeast Asia. And a long time ago, my brother Lewis and I watched a Nova special on a tidal wave that killed hundreds of thousands of people in Southeast Asia in Myanmar, which was formerly Burma. And we used to, me and Lewis would just circulate these same four facts, these little trivial nuggets of truth. And it would drive Christine and my wife crazy. Because once we'd get in that loop, we wouldn't stop. This whole thing. So, my point is that luckily that Nova special got me interested in Southeast Asia. So, when I talked to the guy who is now, he's actually Burmese. And he was born Burmese, and now it's Myanmar. So right away, I stated, oh, Myanmar. Oh, but you would probably be Burmese because you're my age. And right away, he was not only happy or surprised that I knew my history and my geography, but it seemed like he appreciated that I know about his culture because I took the time to learn about it. And it seemed like it meant a lot to him. He comes from, like I said, he comes from a part of Myanmar that is very, it's not, I don't know, it's always in a state of civil war. You have the Cambodian massacre, the Cambodian genocide. We talked about that for a solid 10 minutes. We talked about the 40s and we talked about in 47 when the English, I believe England, was trying to colonize certain parts of Thailand. And he was just extremely appreciative that somebody else. And I look at his name is Sai, and I look at Sai's his history on Uber, and he had gone through like 5,000 rides, and you could tell this guy works a lot. So turned out we both had an interest in sushi, so we started with that, and it ended up going all the way up to the Cambodian genocide of in the 50s and the 40s. So it's amazing how much you can learn from people and learn with people. And as a child, I think it was simply the teachers that made me not care. I was always this walking contradiction. wanted to be filled with info, but I never wanted to take the time to learn it. I wanted it to come to me, and that's not how it works. But when you're in school, everything does come to you. So you kind of expect somebody to fill you in on certain things that you don't know about. You figure, oh, somewhere along the way, I'll learn about that. It's not how adulting works. It's not how life works as an adult. You have to figure shit out on your own. You don't get a teacher. That's a little self-obsessed of you there, Chris. But no, I originally put it up as Walking Contradiction simply because of the Green Day track. And also because of the movie Taxi Driver. Cybill Shepherd tells Robert De Niro to check out this one musical artist. And he, of course, isn't familiar with popular, you know, with pop culture. So he didn't know anything about it. And she said, well, you know, you're like a preacher and a pusher. You're a walking contradiction. And I don't know, Green Day really nailed that with their song, Walking Contradiction. And it really suits this episode because I wanted to talk about the irony and just the weird just project. I don't even know if it's projection or just blatantly lying. Now, we live in a time where we don't know if anything that we see is real unless we're there, you know? It was sad. It's sad. And for some reason, when I'm alone, that's when I really do all my thinking. Like, I don't know. Some of my best thoughts are just come to me when I'm walking down the street. And so, like I said, you know, you expect this shit to come to you, but no, you got to seek out the information you want. And so I am an idiot, but I like to think that I'm pretty well-rounded. And, you know, talking to this guy and he was saying that his English was terrible. And I said, how do you think your English is terrible when we've been talking for over 15 minutes? And I've only had to explain a word to you once. He was trying to find the word, I think, coerce. And so that was it. And coerce is not really a very popular word, so not many people use it in an everyday kind of verbiage or syntax. So the fact that, you know, this guy is also a walking contradiction, you know? This guy looks to be like everybody's idiot, And he comes off as if he's very simple, but he's not. He's very complicated, very complex, and very smart. And so I just find so much contradiction out there that it's starting to make me feel normal. For instance, CPAC recently happened, and we had CPAC had you know, the typical red the right wing nuts. And it was just hilarious that whenever, when one person tried to ask questions, just simple, basic, common sense questions, they kicked him out. And this guy's, I think his name is Matthew Matterson, and he does a lot of political stuff, and he just cracks me up because he got kicked out of CPAC. How the hell can you guys go and break into the White House or break into the damn Capitol? But you're skittish over letting a dude come to your party? Dude, you guys are like the ultimate party crashers. What are you so fucking worried about? So anyway, let's try to think about it and remember that, you know, a long time ago, school was not mandatory. It was never mandatory as a kid. Half a century ago. School was not mandatory. Actually, in the earlier 20th century, school and government were constantly at war with each other because people didn't want to be regulated to having to send their kid to school. And I love how Rick Sanchez says it, because it's very true. School is for stupid people. it's a contradiction in of itself. It's a fucking it's a freaking paradox, but you know what, it's very true. School is kind of for morons. Like, and I don't mean people that go to school are morons. I mean that people that tend to focus on school usually say the dumbest shit. Like, I always leave it to a college kid to say the dumbest thing possible. Like, you know, things are worse than ever. And then you look at the statistic, like, people are just blatantly ignoring fact. And again, saying it's worse now than ever, and it's really not. Crime is actually down. Homicide rate is down. The news, the media, the internet will always have you in a frenzy that things are so dangerous when they're really not. It's just, remember, one negative thought is equal to three positive thoughts. So that means out of three great things that happen to you, it only takes one thing to ruin that. And so it's a 3-to-1 ratio. That's how we work. So we live on drama. It's a fact. Humans thrive with drama. So we make things bigger than they're supposed to be. And we do whatever will sell. So if this show particularly was going to be granted, let's say $100,000, if I would simply change everything about the show and be as naive and as idiotic as possible and give you false information, I would take that money for sure. But I don't think I'd be able to keep up with it. I'd end up getting two to the back of the head because I'd be saying too much. I could never do what Fox News does. And so, like, when I was talking about CPAC, I mean, you have, oh God, there's so many stupid people. So let's talk again about how school was never supposed to be in the only system, and kids were not supposed to be immediately indoctrinated into the school system and then become institutionalized by the time they're out of high school. That wasn't the normal life. Back then, it was the right person for the right job. Didn't matter if you had this degree, this degree, this degree. If the guy that's applying for the job, if he's had, you know, 10 years of experience, they're going to go with that guy. Even if he doesn't have a degree, they're going to go with that guy because he knows what he's doing. And that all changed as time progressed. They wanted children to be indoctrinated. And it was really pushed by the Republican side for kids to go to school, because and so the aftermath of that, we are at a point now where those same people who wanted us indoctrinated in the first place are now saying they don't want their kids talking about their feelings in school. That's probably the dumbest thing I've ever heard. You don't want children, and I love how this Republican said it. She said that children should not be learning about their feelings. They should be learning from, they should be paying for a psychiatrist. So you think every person in America is a rich white girl or something? We don't get no damn therapy. You think a little Mexican kid from Chicago is going to get any money to pay for a therapist? It's not true. Yes, this is exactly the clip I'm talking about, Chris. That clip that you're talking about right here with the child learning about empathy. That's exactly what my point is. I saw that clip, and that was with Matt Matterson. And that's the kid I'm talking about. Yeah, exactly. We're adults now and we can't afford therapy. How the fuck am I supposed to afford therapy for my kid? And what it's really saying is you don't want to talk to your children. I get it, you know? It's scary. It's uncomfortable. I personally don't understand it. I mean, I get it, but I can't empathize with it because I have never lied to my kids ever. Whenever my kids have asked me shit, I have promised to never lie to my children. So my daughter got me in a fucking trap one time and she said, okay, well, how about the whole Santa thing? And I fucking had to say, no comment unless you really want the truth. And fortunately, she really wanted the truth. And, you know, she took it like a champ. She didn't tell her brother. She didn't ruin it for her little brother. She liked knowing more. And that is how everyone should be. So the fact that this woman doesn't want to talk to her child, basically about empathy. And the teacher is trying to say, okay, if a child has two moms, how can you empathize with that? Now, the problem that I had with that question is it's kind of a loaded question. But I kind of see the simplicity of it. I wouldn't have phrased it that way. I think it was a bad phrasing. But because the question isn't really how to empathize. It's will you? Do you have the ability to empathize? And if your children aren't talking about their feelings in school, you know how many school shootings we have every week? Do you really want that like quadrupled in a minute? Because that's exactly what you're asking for. You want children to be massively confused about who they are until they're 18 and then they're shoved out of the house and expected to just understand how the world works. That is a disaster waiting to happen. For children to not learn empathy and not talk about their children, I mean their feelings, is their children talking about their children. Babies having babies, y'all. So that is just the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard, that you could be so oblivious and just so... I don't know. I don't think that woman herself was capable of empathy. That's my point, is that that very person, I think, was a sociopath. And it seems like a smart thing that they're learning to deal with their emotions in a healthy way. Yeah, right. And that's the thing. If you don't have... you know, teachers and shit. You know, kids that go to homeschool honestly are not the same as the kid. I've met probably one normal kid out of all the homeschooled kids I've ever met. My wife was the only one that was just normal. Every other person I met that was homeschooled and was either an idiot or, Just very socially awkward. And how are you going to... Yeah, and I bet she's a great Christian woman. Oh, yeah. Yeah, right. I don't know. It's just insane what the things that the right is asking for and all of the hoops they're going through to distract, and the left, by even responding to this shit, just shows that they're so damn gullible and naive that they're idiots too. This is why I don't pick a side, because I don't think we're meant to have a two-party system. There should be parties within the parties. So if you're a Democrat, what kind of Democrat? Are you a liberal Democrat? Are you a social liberal? I believe in democratic socialism. So where do I fit in? And it is just crazy how... you know, the ironic social detachment that these people show, and these people are red, white, and blue Americans. These people bleed red, white, and blue. They've been born and generated, you know, they have at least three generations of white trash in this fucking thing. You know, they've been here forever. Yet, leave it to the guy from Myanmar to have more culture, more understanding, more empathy, and more self-reflection and self-acceptance. This man knew who he was. And I can't say that for these people. And so you either pick a side and learn, or you shut your mouth and live as a walking contradiction. That's really the two options I think you got. So, yeah, that's it. That's my time. Thank you for spending with me. I told you I had no script for today. So, let me read this. Did you hear about this bill before the governor is trying to pass? And they're trying to go get critical race theory, feminist studies, black history studies, early social studies. And part of the bill that is tenure, the teachers losing behind. Yep. It gets final approval. No. Yeah. Oh, you're talking about DeSantis.
Yeah.
Yeah, Florida governor. See? Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I was going to say that. That was DeSantis. DeSantis also helped. he actually helped with the, what's it called? The I think he actually signed the same bill that helped cause this great meltdown of that bank, the Silicon Valley Bank. And I love how DeSantis is blaming this on wokeism and we're soon going to be living in a wokeocracy. No, we live in an idiocracy, okay? Because you guys are fucking idiots. Half of them are idiots with, you know, a knife behind their back, and the rest of them are just fucking sheeps fucking walking up with dollar bills in their mouth. Literally, like paying him to chop him up. Like, this is the world we live in today. Ass the movie is basically, yeah, we had Ass the movie. It was that January 6th movie where they tried to fucking cherry pick the information and say they were revering the Capitol. A person was squatting and shitting on the floor. That's reverence right there, man. I remember when I first proposed to my wife, man, that was a disgusting cleanup. I mean, but, you know, maybe that's why I'm divorced. I don't know. Love you guys. Love you guys. Take it easy. Chris, I'll talk to you afterwards, and I will see you on the other side. Please stay a cheesy, my friend. Yes, there were a couple of people shitting.
Please note these are a form of social commentary and not in any way meant to put down the ideas and ideals of any political or gender identity. You are all fair game in the eyes of the wicked, and we see you. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go.
Oh shit, I'm Pickle Rick! Motherfucker!
You are now watching Useless Game Episode 3. S2S.
Yeah, what? Very stupid.